Alright, what is up? This is SlowPlays, and I'm here today for some more Dragon Ball Z Universe 2 news for the PlayStation 4, Xbox One, PC, and Nintendo Switch. So, guys, this is some really exciting stuff. We just started off the month of November, and we're getting a big-ass just slew of news going on from the Bandai Namco Japan stream that went on earlier this morning. So we had stuff on Dragon Ball FighterZ as well as Xenoverse 2, the Deluxe Edition trailer, everything that's coming with it, as well as DLC Pack number 5 with the Hero Coliseum Tapion gameplay. We also had Android 13, Deborah, and Super Buhan. It was insane just seeing some gameplay on it. All the characters look amazing, but what I wanted to get into specifically and focus on is the fact that they mentioned a DLC pack number 6 to be released in the first quarter of 2018. So next year, around the same time of Dragon Ball FighterZ, we're going to be getting a DLC pack number 6. So this could potentially be the Dragon Ball Super, I guess, you know, just Tournament of Power arc. We could be getting that, or we could be getting some more movie-based characters or even non-canon, just crazy characters, because with Xenoverse and all the video games, they seem to want to include as many characters as possible. So maybe even some stuff from Dragon Ball Heroes. The fact that we have Dragon Ball Heroes Coliseum sort of esque type of deal going on here, you know, it's kind of just like reminiscent of Dragon Ball Heroes, like the original, you know, Super series and stuff, even the ones on the 3DS and all that. So definitely, it's not completely out of the question that we might be getting some of those characters, or even, you know, characters just from Dragon Ball Super. We'll have to see. I'm very excited to see what they, you know, announce later on. So next year in 2018 is going to be huge for Dragon Ball Z. Xenoverse 2 is still going strong, as well as the fact that Dragon Ball FighterZ is getting some new stuff too. If you guys watch the previous videos that I uploaded, it showcases everything that you need to know with all the new stuff going on for both games. And the last bit of news that kind of, I guess, coincides with it is in Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2, we will be getting costumes for, I believe, Android number 21, if I'm not mistaken. Kind of just, you know, a little trade-off. And then for Dragon Ball FighterZ, we're going to be getting the Supreme Kai of Time's lobby character and Z Stamp, both coming as respective DLCs within the game, and you know, potentially free. I'm not entirely sure yet. None of the translations we're going through. So definitely, it's going to be awesome. I'm very excited for it. Let me know what you guys think about this. Give me some, I guess, opinions on whether or not this is a good idea to have Dragon Ball Super, or maybe even like Dragon Ball Super Heroes or whatever for DLC for Xenoverse 2. Let me know what you guys think about it and what you guys want to see. So I will talk to you guys in the next one. Take care.